Hey guys, Trey Lewellen here with the Unstoppable Core in week number two. We are going to be talking about funnels, actually my top three funnels that I use to build up my company, and I think that you should know about them too. So before we get into basically my top three funnels though, I want to discuss, well, what the heck is a funnel, you know? So we have funnels versus carts. A lot of people are used to the cart analysis or the cart kind of way of building a website at first, because you know that's what Amazon does, right? We build things, items into a cart, we check out, and that's exactly how a cart works. You go and shop for some items, you continue shopping for items, so you kind of build your cart up, and then at the end of the day, you put your credit card in. How a funnel's different is we go out and find that product, right? Or we source just one product, we point to one product, and we grab the credit card at that point in time. Okay, so we grab the credit card, we have a buyer on the line, they've made the purchase, and then what we do is we upsell them, meaning we show them something else, okay? We show them a different item that's congruent with the first item. Hey, since you're interested in this, maybe you're also interested in this. And they can say yes or no, and that, since we already have their credit card, we can say, okay, charge them for that. And then we can say, hey, do you want maybe something like this, maybe another congruent item within the first item they purchased. Also, if they say yes to that, we charge their card again. You're gonna have a really high take rate here versus what you would have in a cart take rate, okay? Because obviously they're adding, they're seeing that price adjust, they're seeing their cart get bigger. Like, how many times have you guys built a cart and then saw the price and were like, whoa, price shock, and then deleted some? Versus in a funnel, you don't really see that. You buy that first item, and you're like, okay, 25, 50 bucks. The next item, 25, 50 bucks. People don't know how to do math, right, in their head. But what they can do is say, you know what, I can afford 25 bucks or 50 bucks. Oh yeah, I can do another $25 to $50, that's okay. But they're not really thinking over the course of the funnel that they just spent $150, right? And then of course, the thank you page. So now that we kind of understand if you want to do a cart kind of website or maybe a funnel, the funnel is gonna produce way more revenue than what a cart funnel will do, in my opinion, okay? So now let's walk you through my top three funnels. I'm gonna show you why. Freemium to premium is funnel number one. Yeah, I kind of made that word up, okay? Freemium, I don't know if that exists in the dictionary, but it sounds cool. All right, so freemium. So what is a freemium item? It's a free item. It's something to give away on the front end, right? To get somebody to say, hey, I'm interested in buying that. You want something that's, then when you look at the item in the funnel, you want it to be and feel impulsive, right? You want them to be like, I need that right now. And then also urgency, right? I don't know how many of these we have. These are gonna sell out really quickly. We're giving them away. We don't have that many more in stock to give out. Right? The next thing, when you're looking at these type of products, you want something that's inexpensive on your behalf, right? Something that doesn't cost you much, maybe 50 cents, $1, $1.50, $2, but has intrinsic value. It looks as if, wow, that's an easy, like I would totally pay 10 bucks for that, okay? Non-breakable, I find that an item that's non-breakable makes it a lot easier on your customer service, your back end, because you don't want something to mail out and then they're like, hey, it broke. That's never a good thing, right? You gotta send another one. Four is you want it small, you want it lightweight, so you're not seeing a lot of money go towards the packaging, okay? When you're shipping it out by the United States Postal Service or UPS, you don't want it that charge to be so heavy because of the weight, right? Five, it's attractive to the consumer, right? It's something that they want, and that's another big thing that we'll talk about later in the videos, is how do you sell something that is attractive versus something that you find attractive, right? Okay, so what a freemium to premium looks like? So we're going from a free item to more of a premium item, something that costs a little bit more. And how we attract that funnel, or how we build it up, is the first page, like we talked about in the funnel, right? When you grab the credit card, you want that free item to be around $2.95 to $9.95. That's gonna have a pretty high conversion rate, usually about 10 to 15%. And all the traffic that you're sending to it is gonna create a huge buyer list for you. After they purchase that $2.95 to $9.95, then we can kind of upsell them, right? We went to a free item into more of a premium. And when I talk about premium, I'm talking about maybe, you know, uplift them into a $10 to $15 item on that first upsell. And then we can lift them up into basically a 30 to 50. So, hey, here's a $10 to $15 item. Would you like that? You know what? Yeah, I'll take that for 10 to 15 bucks. That's not too hard on the pocketbook. Next upsell, 30 to 50 bucks. You know what? Yeah, some people are gonna say 30 bucks is too much for me, but some other people say, you know what? I can afford that as well. And so you'll have different people take different things. What you don't wanna do is swap these two. You don't wanna take them from a really low price, spike them to a really high price, and then back down to a lower price. Sometimes that might work, sometimes not. It's worth split testing, right? Changing it out and seeing if it works for you. So let's kind of put this model on a graph, okay? So right now we have a small item, all right? So we have this low priced item, which is our freemium item, okay? To give you guys kind of another look at this. And then we kind of take them to a $10 to $15 approach, right? Next one up. And then from there, we go to a $30 to $50 item, which puts us on the graph. So as they're going through the funnel, you pretty much see this type of graph. Okay? And then the thank you page. So that is a freemium to premium funnel. It's one of my top three funnels that we use consistently. Next is just a premium funnel. Okay, so what does that look like? Well, a premium funnel looks like a $45 to $97 upfront. Now the conversion is gonna be a lot lower because it's so hard to entry, right? Barrier of entry is a lot harder versus like a $6, $7 item. But what you can push with this type of front end price is a lot of traffic. You can afford a lot more traffic, especially if your margins are great. Okay, so you wanna start with that $45 to $97, and then we can upsell them into a 30 or 50. So this is kind of different, right? This is a little bit different than the freemium and premium where we kind of went up in the graph. In this case, we're going from a high item, which is $45 to $97, down to pivoting down to a 30 to 50. So someone who just spent $100 is easier to buy something next for $30 to $50 because they're like, I just spent $100. Now I can easily say, oh, $30 to $50 versus another $100 or another $200. Okay, so then you got the $45 to $97, we're upselling into a $30 to $50 item, and then again, upsell into a $30 to $50 item, which looks like this on the graph. So if we look at that as the course of how they go, we kind of take this, and then we drop it, and then we go across, okay? So those are how I run a premium funnel. Now here's my favorite. I love this one. I saved the best one for last, because this is a premium into continuity. So what's continuity? It's recurring, right? Mailbox checks, something that someone's paying for as a membership. Maybe they're paying $20 a month, $30 a month for something that you give them. Maybe it's a club. Maybe it's discounts on items. Maybe you send them a newsletter every week. Maybe you let them into a Facebook group, whatever that is, right? So anyways, same type of start, right? We have that $45 to $97 point of entry. So again, you can afford a lot of traffic with this. Then guess what? You upsell them into that $30 to $50 price range. And then again, into a 30 to 50, like I said, $30 to $50, but per month, right? So not only is this a product that they're purchasing, but maybe it's recurring here, okay? So this is now saying, hey, by the way, if you buy this item, when you buy this $30 a month or $40 a month package, we're gonna send you a box every month. We're gonna send you something really cool that you can look into that you're gonna love and talk with your friends about. Now, how's this one look on the graph, right? So again, we have this very high point, same as this one, okay? And then what we do is we come down into that $30 to $50 mark, $30 to $50 mark. But here's where it becomes really nice, is we come across, and then as that continuity builds, so does the long-term value of that customer, because they keep paying $30 a month, $30 a month, $30 a month. This funnel produces a lot of cash, right, over time. And that's exactly what you want when building these premium funnels. Now, here's what's really cool, is you can mix and match stuff, right? These are the top three. There's obviously multiple more funnels that you can build, but these are my top, right? We got freemium to premium, we got premium funnel, and then premium into continuity. You can switch it around, you can do freemium to continuity. You know, you can do all kinds of cool stuff, but these are my top three. And I hope those help you guys out. I wish that you go out and build these funnels yourself, try them out, see which one works best for you, which one works best for your business, and make money with it. Thanks for watching The Unstoppable Core with myself, Trey Lewellen, and we'll see you on next week's call.